Hello, and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning about how to calculate molar masses. We're going to be looking at examples of atoms, molecules, compounds, and hydrates. We're going to go through the concept of really what is a molar mass, which is going to be using your periodic tables to calculate all these different values. So this is meant to help introductory and general chemistry students for how to do the fundamental skills required of you to pass general chemistry. So let's take a look at all these different examples. Let's go to the first one and really how we can do that. And like I mentioned earlier, what we're going to be doing is four molar masses. What this is the mass in grams, and that's representing one mole of a particular substance. So that's for every grams of grams per mole. Now, this could come under many different names depending on who your chemistry professor is or who you are learning this from. Sometimes you might see it as other names like molecular mass, molecular weight, formula mass, formula weight. They're all referring to the same general concept. They might be changing units depending on really what particular thing you are referring to, but they're all using your periodic table. We're going to be focusing on this first one. But mainly grams per mole and how to do those types of conversions, which will be required later in your semesters for how to do mole conversions. Let's take a look at our first example. The first example here is let's do an easy one and just be able to make sure we understand what that concept is of molar mass. So I want to just figure out what the molar mass of just nitrogen atom is. So for this one, when you're looking at your periodic table, you're going to see the following values here when you find nitrogen or any of your elements. And there's a couple different numbers here that are very important. We have up top, we have the atomic number, which tells you how many protons there are, how many electrons there are for a neutral element. The number down here is the atomic mass, which is generally represented in AMU. However, we can directly relate this to measurements that you do in the laboratory setting in grams per mole. So it's a one-to-one conversion. So if you have 14.007 AMU, you also have 14.007 grams of nitrogen for every one mole of nitrogen. So what exactly does that mean? Well, being that I have a single nitrogen atom here, we can say, hey, if I have one mole of this, or 6.022 times 10 to the 23 atoms of it, then that's going to weigh 14.007 grams. So this is what we're going to be doing. Now, when we have, let's say, different amounts of compounds, we got to do a little bit more math here. So let's take a look at the next example, and we'll proceedingly get a little bit harder with each one. With this example, let's find the molar mass of oxygen gas. Well, oxygen gas, whenever someone mentions like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, iodine, bromine, chlorine gas, these are your natural diatomics, meaning they have a subscript of 2 next to each one of them. So what do we got to do here? Well, when we are looking at O2, that tells you that you have 2 moles of oxygen within 2 moles of oxygen atom in 1 mole of oxygen molecule. Okay, so O2 molecule. So it's a conversion term within itself. So how can we actually do the math here? Well, earlier, if we looked at our periodic table, and I grabbed the value earlier, that if we have 15.99 grams of oxygen atom, well, we have a subscript of 2 here. So what we're going to do to find the entire molar mass of this is we're going to multiply that number by 2 because our subscript is 2. So we're going to compensate for that. Now, this is equivalent to every 1 mole of O2 molecule. So when we do that math here, what we are going to get from that is 31.98 grams of O2 for every 1 mole of O2. So this is our molar mass. This is how we can do it for a basic chemical compound. We're just multiplying our molar mass from our periodic table by the subscripts. So we're counting the number of atoms. So we had two oxygen atoms bound together covalently, and we're going to be showing that as well within our calculations too. So if I were to kind of move on to a slightly more, a little bit different one, well, here I have ozone. So ozone is O3. So what that tells you is that, hey, we have the subscript right here. And with that subscript, we have three oxygen atoms that are in this calculation. So we need to take that three, multiply it by the molar mass. So three times 15.999 grams per mole. And what that will get us is a molar mass of 47.97 grams of ozone for every mole of ozone. Okay, so this is the idea here, that when we are calculating those molar masses, we're multiplying it by the subscripts that we see within the chemical formula. Let's go to a slightly harder one. Let's go to the next. With this next example, our molecule is getting a little bit bigger as we go. And what we have to do is the same general idea. So I have propane gas here, which you might use for barbecuing or grilling or maybe cooking at home. So propane has three carbons, eight hydrogens within its formula. So this is what is going to be counting for each of these atoms that we have here. So we can see the three carbons connected, all the hydrogens connected to the respective carbon. So we are going to do our math. So what we have is 3 times 12.01 grams per mole for carbon, right? And you want to put those different units here. We'll put that in parentheses. And what we're going to do is we're going to add that with 8 hydrogens times 1.008 grams per mole of hydrogen. Now, when we take all those values and add them together, what we are going to get is a total molar mass of 44.094 grams of C3H8 for every 1 mole of C3H8. And what this will be used for is a conversion term. So if you want to go from grams to moles within your conversion, or something with propane, this is what you would use right here. So this is a conversion term. And you can go to my other videos as well to see how that conversion term can be used. So the what is a mole video or other videos as well to help you be able to use it and to help you figure out these types of problems. Let's go on to an even harder one with parentheses. Find the molar mass of the following ionic compound. So when it's ionic, what we are looking at is we have a metal bound to a non-metal. So we have our metal here on the left and a non-metal polyatomic. And the thing that's different about this one is notice how we have parentheses. So what exactly is this doing here? Well, it's like math that's being carried out. We need to make sure we are counting our atoms properly. So let's take a look. So on the left-hand side, we have two aluminums based on the subscript that is here. Now, inside of this parentheses, well, we have a 3 that's outside of it. So what exactly is that going to do? Well, it's kind of like an algebra problem. We're going to be carrying out the math on the subscripts that are with inside of this. So what do I mean by that? Well, if on inside I have 1 carbon atom, we're going to be multiplying that by, let's say, if I make this red, we're going to be multiplying this by 3 for our carbon atoms inside. So we'll have a total of 3 carbon atoms, okay? Now, oxygen, in this case, it had, oxygen originally had 3 carbon atoms, and now we're going to be multiplying it by another 3 carbon atoms inside. So we have a total of 9 oxygens, 2 aluminum, and 3 carbons looking at that. So we got to make sure we are properly showing how we're adding all these different pieces up when we are doing our molar masses. So if I'm going to be carrying out the math, each one of these is going to be in their own set of parentheses. So we'll do 2 times 26.982 grams per mole for aluminum. We'll do the same thing for, let's say, for carbon. So carbon, we have a total of 3 of them, and we're going to times that by 12.01 grams per mole of carbon. And then we'll be adding that to oxygen. So I'm going to continue that on the bottom here. And that, then we have a total of 9 oxygens times 15.99 grams per mole. Now, when we add up all these different values together, you're going to get a pretty big molar mass of 233.904 when you go through the mathematics of this. So it's 233.904 grams per mole. And that's for the entire molecule. So when we are reporting that, that means that if you were to go to a balance, let's say in the lab setting, and you measure out 233.904 grams of aluminum carbonate, then that represents 1 mole of that compound. So they are equal to each other. So 1 mole, Al2CO3. So these two terms are equal. So keep that in mind. 1 mole is equal to 233.904 grams of aluminum 2 carbonate. So aluminum carbonate, these two are equivalent to one another, which is really important for when you are doing your calculations to realize that they are equivalent to each other. They're a ratio. They help you be able to cancel your unit. So if you need to go from moles to mass, this is what you would have to do every single time that you do this calculation. Let's go on to our next one, which is involving a hydrate. Find the molar mass of Epsom salt. So Epsom salt, something you can buy in a grocery store or a dollar store, hardware store. And what this one is a hydrate, meaning that we have MgSO4, then I have what looks like a multiply symbol and 7 waters. Now, does that mean that you have to multiply 7 waters? No. So what this is telling you is that we have 7 waters attached to our magnesium sulfate. So they are like little things surrounding it. So I have a little magnesium sulfate over here. Now, so what that means is I have 7 waters that are completely surrounding this particular molecule here. So when we want to write this, we will have these 7 little waters that are completely around our structure, just like so. So we're going to take it and count our atoms just like we did before and add up all their molar masses, each one individually. You do not want to multiply the 7 waters times magnesium sulfate. You're going to be adding 7 waters onto this. So when we are doing our math here, so the first one, right, if we have our individual properties, so we have 1 magnesium that is in this compound. So 1 times 24.3 grams per mole, and that's for Mg. We'll then add that to our sulfur, right? We have 1 sulfur that is in our formula. So that's 1 times 32.07 grams per mole. And then we have our oxygens, which are in the compound itself. So we're going to do that a little separately. We have 14 times 15.99 grams per mole for our oxygens. Okay, so now we have to do for our water component. So we are going to add these parts together. And then we're also going to add our 7 waters as well. So how do we go about that? Well, we have a coefficient of 7. And then we had 2 hydrogens, so it's 7 times 2, which is 14. Multiply that by 1.008 grams per mole. So we're adding up all these little pieces here, and it's a lot. And now we'll have a total of 7 oxygens that are in this compound times 15.99 grams per mole. So that means that overall, you have 11 oxygen atoms in this compound, but we're just separating them between the water component and the other parts from earlier. So sulfur and then hydrogen. All right, so now when we have all these values, we're going to add them all up to make 1 big hydrate. So when we do all the math, we'll take 24.3 plus 32.07. plus 4 times 15.99, plus 14 times 1.008, plus 7 times 15.99 So when you do that, we will get 246.372 grams of MgSO4 and 7 waters all over 1 mole of the same compound. It is a little bit of work to do that hydrate, but it's something that allows you to really see that, hey, that this is not a multiply. We need to add these individual pieces when you're doing that molar mass. Let's do another one with a bigger covalent molecule. So these molecules can get really big and really massive. Hydrates, I think, are the hardest, but hopefully this will help you be able to see that firsthand for if you have to do it for homework or an exam or even in a lab sometimes. Let's go to our last example. All right, if we want to calculate the molar mass of, let's say, something like a biomolecule or an organic molecule or a biomolecule like serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter molecule, it's responsible for happiness. So if you're given a molecule that looks like the one all the way on the left-hand side here, right, you might have to go through and count all the individual atoms that are here. So when we count them all up, what you would get is that there's 10 carbons, 12 hydrogens, 2 nitrogens, and 1 oxygen. So we got to go through that entire process of adding all those up, just like how we did earlier, by taking all of them and adding them. So if, once again, we wanted to find the molar mass of serotonin, we can go through that process. So the first thing we would do is, being that carbon, we have 10 carbons, and each one is 12.01 grams per mole of carbon. We then have 12 hydrogens, and that's 1.008 grams per mole of hydrogen. And then we have nitrogen, we have a total of 2 of them, times 14.001 grams per mole of nitrogen. And then we have oxygen, which there are a total of 2 of them, or sorry, 1 of them here, and that's 15.99 grams per mole. So what we will do with all those little pieces is you're going to take them and add them all up, and what you will get for a final answer is 176.206 grams of serotonin for every 1 mole of serotonin. Okay, so that's a conversion term that we can use for these types of problems, so that if you need to cancel them out, do your mathematics. Now you know how to do molar masses, so go out there, go figure out those problems on your homeworks, on your exams, and do well in your chemistry course. I hope that this video helped. Please hit that like and subscribe button if it did, and I hope to see you back for future videos. Bye now.